small case, small footprint, you can hold it in your hand, it's rechargeable, and then the camera lens is so small. So it just ended up being an automotive camera that they get in there and kind of scope things out inside of an engine. Let me show you the old version. This is the old version. We work with, in our industry, or in our region, a lot of gas furnaces, gas burning appliances that have the potential to release carbon monoxide. So there are heat exchangers in each one of our furnaces. I was shown this by another technician, but it's an automotive camera, and we're able to get inside the really tight spaces and inspect the heat exchanger of the furnace. So we go in through the limit hole and look up and down for cracks, any sort of splits, rust, cells that are getting brittle, damaged, to make sure that they're not going to have any carbon monoxide dangers in the home, right? So carbon monoxide has no smell, so there's no odor, there's no indicators that it's in the home, and nobody's going to come behind us unless it's going to be the fire department, because somebody had a nice detector or something that caught it. So it's really important that we take it very seriously and thoroughly inspect the heat exchanger to make sure that we don't have any issues. Mm-hmm. Right?
So you inspect all furnaces with this thing?
I do, yeah. Okay. So you can see here, I don't know if you can catch that on the video, but there's a crack in a furnace. These are a couple photos I took.
I see, yeah.
So right here on the bottom of the cell, you got a crack. I know these look foreign to a lot of people, but we're basically getting into these tight areas that we can't just see without taking the whole thing apart. So this is a way that I can get down in there and take a look at all the bends and turns, because when metal gets hot and then cold and then hot and then cold, it expands and contracts to the point to where it gets extremely brittle. Like a paper clip, you consistently bend the paper clip back and forth, back and forth. It's gonna eventually break, and where it always breaks is on that first bend, because the metal's been weakened. So essentially, this is just a way that I can get in there and look at every bend and hole to make sure that it is structurally sound and safe.
What's that called again?
This is just an automotive inspection camera. So this is the only one that, but it was small enough for me to be able to get in there and wiggle around. This specific brand is Teslong. I bought it on Amazon. It was an Amazon find, and they had a good deal on it. So I've been happy with it so far, and I think, 10 technicians have it now.
Wow.
So yeah, it's kind of taken over the old version. Let me show you the old version. This is the old version. So this thing here would have a full-on television. So the TV, take this big old cord, plug it in to this. So I would take this, plug this into it, power up my TV, and I would be able to inspect it. But as you can see, the head on this one is significantly larger than the one in there. The old one and the new one.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Yeah, I would say that's a bit of an improvement.
So, like, literally this little thing that I'm looking at right here?
That's the camera.
Okay, so, and that's what you're trying to fit through versus that thing over there.
Yeah, so
that's wild.
A limit, I would say, is about the size of a half dollar or a quarter.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This here would be very difficult to fit in there. This one here, I can fit in all sorts of different places to inspect the heat exchanger. So it actually improves the amount of area I can cover. It takes very high definition videos and photos. I can take stills with it. It's got an SD card in there, so I can save them to make sure that the homeowner can see it. Transparency is key. You want to make sure that they know what's going on. They can see it with their own eyes.
Where did you get the idea to use an automotive one?
I didn't even think of the automotive side of it. It was more just what type of camera is small enough and just I can transport anywhere. Mm-hmm. Small case, small footprint, you can hold it in your hand, it's rechargeable, and then the camera lens is so small. So it just ended up being an automotive camera that they get in there and kind of scope things out inside of an engine. So, yeah.
Cool.